In this vlog, we would like to deal with the implementation of a network call in our Flutter application. So previously we have seen various implementations for network call, like we have made use of a retrofit library. We have made HTTP network calls for all the CRUD operations like post, get, update and delete. And also we have seen through getex implementation, and there are various network call tutorials we have seen in our channel over here. So I'm providing the link in the description section below if you are watching this tutorial for the first time, so you can just go through them. And in this part of this tutorial, we'll be making use of a Dio library and try to perform a network call. It's as quick as possible as we write the code. It's just like a one or two lines of code, that's it. And we'll be making a network call. If you're already aware of Dio library, or if you're new to this particular concept, I suggest you to watch till the end of this tutorial. It will be like a refreshment for you if you are having a knowledge of Dio library. And if you are a beginner, then it will be very much useful for you to understand the implementation. So now let's get started. So the very first thing we need to do is, like, we need to add the dependency here. And the current version is 4.0.6, and you may update the version depending upon when you are implementing this particular tutorial. So quickly, let's try to create our basic application so that we can make use of a Dio call here. So it's like a basic, we go through every app, every tutorial. So run app, and inside which let us specify my app over here. And now let's try to create a stateless widget, and let's call it my app. And inside the container, let's try to add a material app here instead of a container, and inside which let's specify its scaffold. And inside the scaffold, let us specify the body here. For now, I'm just specifying column here, so that you can add multiple widgets here. So basically, I just want to add a button so that we can click it and we can perform a network call. And here, let's try to specify a label for our button. It's like fetch data. So I think you are now aware like what kind of network call we are going to make. So yes, our code is now ready. And now let's try to make use of the Dio library and make a network call here. I'm going to create a method here. The method will take care of calling the API here. So whenever we tap on this particular button, we can make use of this particular method and implement a network call. So let's create a method like fetch data. And as usual, network calls are asynchronous, so let's make it asynchronous. And make this particular method asynchronous, so that we need to wait for the response and then try to print the response. Create a variable to and initialize it. Okay. And it's asking for us to import the library. So we have added the library in the dependency, right? So we need to just import it. And now let's try to capture response here by making a network call. So add await, so that we need to wait for some time. And now let's make use of this particular Dio object and create a get request here. So as we have added the title here, you might have already known that we are making use of a get request call. And try to specify the path over here. So what is the path we are going to consider is, here I've just tested with the postman and the network call, and the API is working perfectly. So just try to copy this particular URL here, and you can observe the response over here. So let's try to add the same URL here as our path here. Okay. And also you need to specify where here, so that we can make use of the response here to print. So print response dot, within the response we are having data, extra headers, so all these things, and also status code is also there. So let's try to print status code, and after which let's try to print our data to string. And now let's try to run this particular code and see the output. And now let's specify this particular fetch data method here inside our pattern click. So don't forget to specify it over here. And now let's try to open the simulator and try to run our code here. So this tutorial is going to be very, very quick one. And in our coming tutorials, we'll be going to see how to implement a post network call and how to download a file and delete, update and all these things. So just let me know in the comment section below so that we can just plan accordingly. So here I've just aligned my button to the center of the screen like this, like I've specified a column, right? So within the column, I have added a center tag here, and also I specified main axis alignment to the center. And now let's try to tap on this particular button and try to observe the console here. So whenever we tap on this particular button here, you can see we have got the status code like 200, and just like our postman, we have got the complete response printed in our console. So yes, this is it for this particular tutorial implementation of Dio library. And we have made use of a get request here. So in the coming tutorials, we will be seeing more on Dio library implementation in Flutter application. And if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.